What's going on, guys? Welcome once again to Teen Bodybuilding India. This is your friend Shreyas. So friends, today we are going to show you all the shoulder and arm workout that we did in our apartment gym, because yesterday was Sunday and the gym was closed. So the first exercise was for our rotator cuffs, just to warm up. So one quick thing, guys, this exercise is called external rotations, so you can see how I'm doing it. But I want to share one thing quickly, guys. So people think that if we perform this at the beginning of the workout, our rotator cuffs are completely safe, but that is not exactly the case. If you are doing this exercise at the beginning of your workout, make sure that you don't use very very heavy weights, because what happens is, yes, your rotator cuffs will be getting a good warm up, but you can't lift enough weights, okay? And if you try to lift heavy weights, there are still chances of your rotator cuffs getting injured. So I don't mind if you do higher reps, but don't use heavy weights for your rotator cuffs when you do it at the beginning of your workout. So this is my friend Suhas. So today we will talk something about progressive overload, the importance of increasing the load at least every 2 weeks, because the only way you are going to promote hypertrophy in your body is hypertrophy in your muscles is by increasing the weights. So Suhas has been working out for over 2.5 years. I just met him 3 months back. The weights he was lifting was not at all good enough, guys. So now we work out together and I'm happy that he can lift heavy. Actually, he could lift very heavy, but no one was there to push him. And the same with me. I also used to work out alone for quite a while, and now I can lift heavy. For example, for the seated dumbbell press, I was not able to lift 35 kg dumbbells, but now I'm easily able to do 10-12 reps for the seated dumbbell press with 35 kilograms. Now the next thing, the only way to get strong on a movement is doing the movement consistently for a good period of time. I have not done this exercise for like 5 months, so it is difficult for me to suddenly increase the weights. Here I was doing 17.5 kilograms on each side with the 15 kilogram barbell. You can see, guys, I used to lift 32.5 kilograms on each side with a 20 kilogram barbell, okay, like 5 months back, because I was used to that movement. But since I didn't do this movement from a long time, it became difficult. Here I am doing 22.5 kilograms on each side. I think I did 8 reps over here. A very good exercise, guys, the overhead press. You should try it out, because your core gets strengthened. Many people do planks and all the things, but okay, your core gets strengthened there as well, but this is basically a compound movement. Your front deltoids is being worked, guys, but your core is also being worked. It gets strengthened, and doing this once in a while is pretty good. But if you want to get stronger on this movement, you should be doing this exercise maybe every week, because your body needs to understand the movement. Your body needs to learn the movement. The same thing that I did with the deadlift video. If you are not been doing deadlift for a long time, no. The maximum I could go was 25 on each side. So as you saw, the last set I did 5 reps. So the next exercise that we did was dumbbell lateral raises. Here we did 4 sets. The dumbbell we were using was 9 kilograms, because the maximum dumbbells in the gym was 9 kilograms. So actually it was good, because for the lateral raises, the perform is important rather than the weight you use. Because look, guys, the delt muscles are not one of the biggest muscles in your body. So it is good to have a mix of heavy weight as well as lighter weight. By lighter weight, I don't mean doing light, very very lightweight and doing like 30 reps. No, I'm talking about a weight where you could do like 10-12 reps, because that is the best range for promoting hypertrophy, as well as you can lift very heavy with like 6-8 reps. Keeping that aside, I think you can see that my back, I have made some good gains in my back, guys, because I've been dirty bulking. You guys might be knowing that I just stopped bulking like maybe 1.5 months back, and my current weight, I won't actually talk to you about my current weight, but I'm cutting, guys. I'm feeling pretty good about my diet. You can see that my rear deltoids, my back muscles, all are looking pretty good. My traps are also visible. So a very good exercise for your lateral head to get the round look. So people want that V taper from the front as well as from the back. So lateral head plays a very important role. My lat spread, guys, look at my lat spread. I think it looks pretty good. So after that, once we hit our front delts and the lateral head, we are going to hit the posterior deltoids. This is called the bent over lateral raises or the bent over rear delt flies. A very good exercise for your rear deltoids, guys. Again, we used the 9 kilogram dumbbells and we did like 15 reps, I guess. It is very difficult to isolate your rear delts, guys. So again, I'm doing my lat spread just to show you guys that I made some good gains, all kinds of gains. So as you can see that you need to bend over on a bench and you need to perform this exercise in the way I'm doing. So you can see that the form and all the other things and how to perform this exercise. So I think we performed again 4 sets of this exercise and this was the end of our what you call delt workout. So after that we went on to some biceps, heavy biceps, like 5 sets of 5 reps for the biceps. Okay, so look, my form is not perfect. I was using again 22.5, actually 24 kilograms on each side, so my form is not proper, I know that. But what you can see is I'm lifting heavy for 5, 6, 7 reps. Okay, so I'm failing at that range. So what it does is it will actually help in hypertrophy, especially if you're bulking. But while dieting, guys, it is very, very important to lift heavy. It's not that lightweight and higher reps will give you muscle definition. Your diet is what will give you muscle definition. Okay, so lift heavy even while you're dieting. I'm not telling always lift for 5-6 reps, but once in a while, if you do at least once a week, if you do for biceps where you do heavy weights and like very low reps, like 5-6 reps, it will help you in preserving the maximum amount of muscle. After that, we did some hammer curl, dumbbell hammer curls. We did 3 sets of this for 12 reps, I think. So since the dumbbells were not that heavy, we could do 10 to 12 reps. But still, the first exercise that we did, which was the overhead press for our shoulders, that took a lot out of us, guys, and it was difficult for us. You can see that my arms are looking good, my delts are looking good. I'm getting lean, guys. I'll be ripped pretty soon. So thanks for all your support, guys. It meant a lot because it was difficult for me as well as for you, because you guys wanted to see me in my best form. But I'm getting there, guys. It was a very good bulk, I feel. You can see that I have gained some pretty good mass in almost all parts of my body. The only thing I'm concerned is my chest. Okay, so we'll see how it goes, and there is room for improvement all the time, guys. You never stop growing and you never stop learning in the world of fitness. So the last exercise was 6 sets of dips. Okay, as you can see that I'm not bending forward or something, I am not leaning forward, because we are concentrating on our triceps. The difference is we are going all the way up, we are locking out at the top. So that's the end of our shoulder and arm workout, guys. Just another workout, but I hope this was informative. So guys, if you want some online training from me, you can get it. You can contact me at shreyasrocky@gmail.com. And we have one more good news for you. The health card coupon code is back. You'll get 10% offer on purchase above 2499. Thanks for watching, guys.